Welcome back to Big Brother, where tonight two anguished creatures are in turmoil as they wait for you to put one of them out of their misery. You can humanely end one housemate's suffering by administering a simple, lethal phone call. These decisions are always a tad difficult, but believe me, it is for the best. We're going back to BBHQ, and Noreen is about to be one friend lighter when another one of her allies washes their hands off her.
4:53 p.m. Isaac and Noreen are in the bedroom.
Thank you for coming in. If I do stay, I'm so excited about all the things that are going to happen.
Oh, man. Even if you just stay for one more week.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's still negative thinking, but we would have so much fun.
Mm.
Some of the housemates are in the garden.
When are you two just going to get it on?
We're not.
We're all friends.
They're just friends.
Someone tells me it's friends. I respect that.
We're all friends in this house.
Yeah, you think we are.
B has come to the diary room.
I wanted to come and see you because I'm feeling a bit funny about Noreen. I've decided that... I think that... Well, there's a couple of things. First of all, I lent her this top and she did say, to be fair to her, that she would wash it. And I was like, oh, no, don't worry. But it really does smell. I just think that's rude. But anyway, that's the least of our problems. You've brought a new person in. I don't know, I don't really know many people like Isaac. He's making an effort, but he's just a weirdo. It's like he's stepped out of American Pie. Apparently, as soon as Isaac walked through the door, she realised that she's head over heels in love with him. And if she's head over the heels in love with him, what the hell was she doing with Siavash? I think that hindsight is a wonderful thing, and I think that Noreen is a selfish attention seeker, and I don't like her at all. I think that her behaviour last night and today has been absolutely despicable. I think that she should be ashamed of herself, and I think that she's really, letting herself down completely. Nobody is on her side. Nobody thinks that what she's done is justifiable. And, you know, we've been hearing about her ex-boyfriend, but not in particularly favourable terms. And then he comes through the door and she drops Siavash like a cold bag of sick and is hopping into bed with this frat dude. But if she does love Isaac, I still don't understand why she is being, frankly, such a bitch about the situation. She seems to have no comprehension whatsoever of the embarrassment and humiliation that she's caused Siavash, and she just doesn't seem to care. Plus, he seems like a right noddy. And regardless of what happens tomorrow, if Noreen goes, I'm not looking forward to having him in the house. He just seems like a big lump of Americanized arrogance. If this is the love of Noreen's life, fine. Good luck to her. But in light of her actions and reactions, she is not my friend. And I wash my hands of her completely. She's just a proper little hussy.
Six:35 p.m. Noreen and Isaac are in the bathroom. Hera, Lisa, Charlie and Marcus are in the living room. Some of the housemates are in the bedroom. Earlier, some housemates discussed going to the diary room in their towels to plea for Marcus to stay.
Can we all fit in the diary room?
Come on, David.
Come on, Claire, Claire. Come on. If you don't agree with it, then that's fine.
El nome mio nessun.
Where are you going?
Diary room.
Really? What are you going to ask for?
Huh?
What are you going to ask for?
Nothing. Nothing. There, we just...
Towels.
Ask for what?
Mm-hmm.
You said
towels.
Towels.
It seems a bit harsh than just to not tell Noreen if she asks, what are you doing in the diary room? To...
She didn't.
No, she did. She said, what are you guys doing in the diary room? What are you guys asking for?
Yeah, she did.
Like, and you said nothing.
Oh, did I?
Yeah.
I love to Robin Lawson.
Right. But, yeah, well... Mm.
Oh, I'll tell her, then.
OK, yeah, rock and roll.
Yeah. Let's just go in there now. All of us, guys, by the way.
Isn't it too mean?
We are going into that room too.
Let me in.
It's only mean because... Why is it mean?
I don't know. Mm-hmm. It's a bit mean.
How's
do
that
we
mean
want,
to
do we want to stay?
If you want someone to stay, we're not saying...
It's only by default that that would mean, unfortunately, Noreen going.
Half,
if I was saying let's all go in and let's say we hate Noreen...
Yeah.
I'm not saying that, I'm just saying want Marcus
then
to stay.
I'd see what you mean. Oh. We're going in to say something positive,
yes,
that we love Marcus.
OK, yeah.
And that's it.
We've got the beans, we've got bread, we've got cereal.
We're going to be living like kings this week.
Eh?
I'm like, we've done all this really good, watch. And everyone will fuck me off tomorrow, I'll go home tomorrow.
For exactly the same price, right, it was no sugar. Right, I mean, it had sugar in it.
So at least half of the people in here have nominated. So even if you have nominated someone, if you change your mind about it, then...
What's up, man? Up. What's up?
Jeez.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
I just want to express our appreciation for Marcus.
I
want Marcus so badly.
Show our love for Marcus.
We'd be very upset if he had to go home.
Yeah, we don't want him to go.
Very sad if he had to go, and I would personally feel very, very... like a very good friend. I've lost a very, very good friend.
Yeah, he's been there for me in some really tough times in this house. Like, I'm just so much in his debt and gratitude for, like, yeah, everything he's done, like, helping not just me, but everyone in this house, like...
Giving advice and stuff when you're feeling down. He tells you how to look at the situation and what he thinks about it and stuff.
We love Marcus.
Yeah, Marcus all the way.
Yay for Marcus.
Go, Marcus.
Give me an M.
Woo.
Give me an A. Give me an R.
How do you spell it?
C.
Give me a K.
Give
me a U.
Give me a
S.
S. Marcus! Oh,
Marcus.
What do you say, Charlie?
I like Noreen and I like Marcus.
Yeah,
just as both.
Both,
so if either go, I'll be upset either way.
Yeah.
I know we'll be.
That's true.
But I'm not going to, like, protest for one, because I don't want Noreen to go either, so that means I have to do for them both. Do you know what I mean? I'm not a kind of person to
that's
say...
That's true, yeah.
So...
Because I think, like, this, we're all, like, ganging up on one person. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So I think, yeah, we're friends with both, we like both, and leave it up to the public. You know?
(laughs) 10:59 p.m. Lisa, B, David and Dogface are in the living room.
I reckon B could do modelling because she's got the height for it.
I said that.
And you've definitely got the weight for it as well.
No.
I'm sure
because
I could. You know, because I say B's,
no,
B's a dark horse.
That's very kind of you, but
I'm sure
I could
roger and not fall off.
I heard that proposal.
No, I mean, you know.
No, because have you got to be a certain height to be like a catwalk model?
I'm not about like. Yes, we 5 foot.
Well, they like you to be about 5'10", don't they?
5'11" you have to be to do catwalk.
That's what they said with me. The only thing that lets you down is your height, but other than that, you would have been a supermodel.
Glamour, you have to be. They're trying to bring it in now for glamour, like you have to be over 5'5".
What are you?
5'4".
But you're all right, though,
but it's more.
I say 5'5".
It's more your body, isn't it? You know, like your boobs and stuff.
The glamour, yeah. It's not. There's nothing about the boobs. People think
well,
it's like how big your boobs are. It's not. It's what's it's the face they look at.
Charlie, Noreen, and Isaac are by the pool.
How can I go?
Oh, dear, I really don't mean it. Mm. Those people went in with the towels in a protest.
Who?
Marcus.
What does that mean? What towels?
Did you not know?
No, what happened?
Nothing about everyone, like, stripped. Well, I didn't do it, asked, and I says, oh, yeah, I says, I'm not doing one, like, what the fuck, kind of thing.
So they all went in for one, and not me. Well, that was really nice.
Who's all? Who's they all?
B, Freddie, Sophie, Rodrigo.
Get me in trouble.
Oh.
I thought you knew.
All of them did what?
Know?
Went in to
see. You did? So you seen them, didn't you?
Mine turned to say, keep Marcus in and make sure Noreen gets out.
People are so grimy. Oh, my goodness.
Oh.
And look at, they're sitting there smiling, too.
Shh, I said to you.
Wow.
This house makes people evil.
Well, in the end, it's not up to this house, it's up to the public.
That's not very nice, though, because people sit there and pretend to be my friend to my face then.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't believe I said that.
Hmm?
I shouldn't have said.
No.
No, you should have said that. I appreciate it.
Yeah, that's, no, at least you're being truthful. People are being two-faced. Real two-faced, so.
Whatever, though.
I thought you knew.
No, they said nothing.
I thought they would have told you. Shit, no, I'm a little...
Well, at least I know who put me up for nomination, then.